Hey, happy new year everyone, it's retired at 40. My new year's resolution is to heat my greenhouse all year round. And I'm gonna try and do it with this inexpensive windmill. It's actually Windmill brand, and the model is DB400. You can pick these up on Amazon or eBay, relatively inexpensive. I think they're around $350 to $400. It claims to be a 400 watt wind turbine, but we're gonna give it the test today. First thing we're gonna do is open it up and just kind of see what all is in here, what you get for the $350 to $400. Okay, what do we get in the box? It looks like this is the body of the windmill. You get a charge controller, which is kind of nice that it comes with one. I don't know how good a quality it is. A user manual. This looks like a nose cone, a parts bag. And then here's your blades. So my first impressions of this are pretty good. Nothing really seems like it's flimsy. It's all pretty well built, which obviously it needs to be if it's being exposed to weather and wind, rain, snow, ice, you know, all that good stuff that kind of just puts a beating on this constantly. But nothing's flimsy. Everything seems like it's pretty good quality.
Just gonna show you the box real quick. It says it's 400 watts. That seems like a pretty ambitious statement on their part, but we'll see what it truly does. It does say that it has a built-in charge controller, which is kind of cool. That's gonna limit the voltage that it puts into your battery so it doesn't overcharge it. And then on this side, you have some specs. It says 400 watts once again, rated speed. Your output voltage is 0 to 15 volts. Minimum cut-in wind speed is 6.7 miles per hour. Survival wind speed is 110, so it doesn't recommend going over 110, and that would be with the brake on. Suggested battery capacity is greater than 50 amp hours.
It's really important not to put this bag on your head because you don't want to suffocate, as the sticker says. So you're supposed to actually mount this to a pole before you put the blades on, but just for the purpose of this video, I'm gonna put the blades on just so you can see what it takes. There's really not much to it. It takes three bolts in each blade. There's three blades. And it is kind of nice because they give you the Allen key and the wrench. You know, a lot of places anymore, they don't even give you the tools that you need to put stuff together. One thing I think I would change on this is they just give you straight washers. There's no lock washers. And a lock washer, if you don't know what it is, it's the one with a little slit in it. And what that does is it keeps pressure on the nut. It keeps the nut from loosening itself up over time with vibration and just movement back and forth. I'll probably do that before I actually get this mounted. I'll add some lock washers. All right, that was really, really easy. Now all you gotta do is just snap this nose cone onto here. So I've got kind of a temporary pole set up on the second level of our house, just to kind of see how this thing moves, what kind of wattage it's gonna put out. So let's head up there.
Okay, so I'm on the second story of my house. I have a temporary pole just leaning there. I'm gonna take some electrical conduit clamps and clamp it to that pole, and then I can actually put the wind turbine up on top of that pole. So I did actually take the blades off. I did also find my first weak spot of this thing, and that is the nose cone. When I was putting the nose cone on, it cracked it. The nose cone's really, really fragile. The plastic is really cheesy. And so that's my first thing that I'm not liking about this. I'm gonna have to glue this back together or put some sort of epoxy or something back on it. But I did make an attachment to go onto that 1-inch pipe. The diameter of this post is gonna be 1.5 inches, and then you slip this rubber grommet over the top of it, and then you feed this through and then tighten it down. I went ahead and drilled a hole in this so I can feed my wires through it, and then I'll tighten it down. Okay, next we're gonna hook up this brake controller, and it should be really easy. Everything's color-coded. The red is just your positive, and then the brake is actually just the green and the yellow wire. And what this brake does, if you have a crazy storm where you have really, really high winds, and it's just, it's not good for the windmill, I think what they say is 30 miles an hour, which doesn't sound like much to me, but you can manually flip this brake on, and it will actually shut the windmill down. It'll stop the blades instantly, just so it doesn't get damaged in high winds. Okay, I've got my connections made up at the windmill, and then I've actually run the wires down into the garden area where I'm gonna put my brake. If you're using the brake, you just put the red lead and the yellow lead together, and then your negative would go to the battery. So I've had this up for about a week now, and we've had basically no wind for about a week until today. And it got a storm kind of blew in and got a little bit nasty. I just wanted to show you the difference between having the brake on and the brake off. So I woke up and turned the brake on last night because it was really, really blowing hard. And right now the brake is on. So it's just barely turning the blade. It's still turning it. So with the brake on, it keeps producing power, but it just slows the blade down so it doesn't get to a dangerous speed. So I'm gonna go out and I'm gonna turn the brake off and show you the difference. Okay, so now that the brake is off, you can see that the wind can kind of just take its course and blow the blade as fast as the wind is traveling. So now I think it's a good time, since we've got a good wind, to take an unloaded meter reading. It is a nasty day out. Even the coyotes are not having very much fun today, but we've got a nice consistent wind. So it's a good day to test the turbine. All right, so we're about 8 right now. I'm gonna connect it to the battery. And obviously, if we just touch it to the battery, we're gonna have the battery voltage, which is right now about 12.7. So in order to figure out what this is going to do with a load on it, we're going to have to hook something up to it. Alright, so I've got the two heat lamps hooked up and into a power inverter right now. It hasn't seemed to really phase the turbine. A lot of times if you get something that's really under a load, it'll start slowing the blades down, but it's 125 watts of light bulbs, 11.9 volts, so you can see that it's drawing out of the battery. So there, I turned everything back off and it's at 12.4 again. I'll watch this for a second and see what we can get our peak to be. There's 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So the wind's picked up just a little bit. I'm gonna give this one more shot. I can see the needle on the amp meter just kind of spiking up every once in a while. So I wanna see just what one more reading is, one final reading. All right, so now that I'm out here, of course it's not doing what I wanted it to do. It's hovering right around 6. I did see it spike up to about 19, and I saw the amp meter get up to almost 10. So I'm gonna call that best case scenario, because I don't think I would want to be anywhere near this thing if it was up in the 20 amp range. There we go. There was a 19 for a second. So we did get a 19 on there. That is with no load. So once again, I'm gonna call that best case. So let's go do some quick math and see if we can figure out what the realistic wattage on this is. So did our inexpensive Amazon wind turbine live up to its 400 watt expectation? Hardly. Even at its peak unloaded performance, it was only at 19 volts and 10 amps. And if you take the volts times the amps, that will give you the wattage, which is only 190 watts. And obviously, if you put that under a load, that would dramatically decrease that wattage value. So if you found this video helpful, make sure you give me a thumbs up. If you've never joined us on this channel, we do some self-sustained living, some gardening, some cooking, some grilling, and you get to join me and my family on retiring at the age of 40. In the meantime, this is Retired at 40, reminding you to live life simple, and we'll catch you next week.